The brother has asked me a question that they have to pay in the Akhirah, or it could be in dunya also. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The brother has asked a question, if the sins they commit and they have to pay in dunya or the akhirah. But first of all, we have to understand something. On the face of the earth, except the messengers, everyone commits sins. The messengers are the only one who committed the least sins, but their sins and their mistakes are forgiven because they are chosen to be the messengers. Every human being makes a mistakes, and every human being makes a sins, but the whoever goes back to Allah and asks for the repentance and forgiveness, Allah does forgive them. And if they do not die in the same state without asking forgiveness, and they just die in the same state of committing sins till they die. So another question was asked, if the Muslim is going to be paying for the sins in dunya and akhirah, or it's only in akhirah. It really all depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because maybe some of the corrupted human beings which are committing like more sins, and Allah gives them the free will to do whatever they want. Sometimes we have to understand that some of the human beings, they commit sins, Allah punish them in dunya, so in akhirah they will be wake up as a pure. And some of them, they will not be punished in dunya, rather Allah has given them a free will, and it's like, you know, you lose the rope and you just do whatever you want to do. So some of them are like that. Allah does not like pull their rope, and Allah does not punish them, but rather Allah has set them a free, so they can commit sins as much as they can. So Allah will not catch them while they are alive, because they might have the very severe punishment in the day of judgment. So Allah let them go. So there was many sahaba used to sin and commit in adultery when they used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, oh Prophet, please punish us, because we do not want to get caught in the akhirah, because we know that the akhirah punishment is unforgivable, and the punishment of akhirah is way unlimited compared to we are living in on the earth. So it's like that. Let's take it like that. Some of them is going to be punished in the dunya, and they will be clean on the akhirah, and some of them going to be having a severe punishment, and they are set loose on the earth. So those Muslims who are under a strong trials, so basically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a great blessing when somebody has like a great trial on the earth. On the Muslim, it's really a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah wants that person to wake up as a pure person on the day of judgment, and he will have no more sins because he was put into the bad trial on the earth. So for an example, it says in a chapter 67 verse number 2, where Allah says, Alladhi khalaqal mawta wal hayata لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah has created a life and a death to test you who are better in deeds, not someone who has a money or someone who does not have a money. So those people who are beggars, has less fortune people, they are Allah is testing them, their patience. And similarly, and those who has a normal risk, and those who has a money, whose life is being very nice, and they are very comfortable. So Allah is basically testing them with the money, how they react when it comes to the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when somebody has a money and they're living a beautiful life, sure, we should not think of that person to be a very blessed person, because we don't know that. Maybe Allah gave them a money and they have a beautiful life. Maybe Allah is testing them, how will they be living a life on the earth. Let's say if they are not rich, but they have a normal risk, but still in that time also Allah is testing them, how they would be reacting, how much commandments they are following. And similarly, those people who are less fortunate, those people who are disabled, those people who are beggars, so Allah is also testing them. So basically, those who have the most trial on the earth, those Muslims, so basically it's a great blessing of Allah, those people who had great trials on the earth. So Allah is wiping out their sins so they can be wiped out, and on the day of judgment when they wake up for their accounting, their sins will be wiped out, and they will be surprised because Allah put them in a trial on the earth. So those whose risk is normal, those who are given too much money, they are the one who is going to be more accountable compared to those people who are less fortunate. So what we have to do, when Allah says inna Allaha ma'as sabirin, Allah is with those who have a patience. So even if somebody is disabled, somebody is a beggar, somebody is a less fortunate, somebody has a going through a great trial, so just if we have to have adopt patience like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And because there's a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the person who is a sabir, he is going to be entered into Jannah without an accounting. So it's a great glad tidings for those. So in every condition we have to say Alhamdulillah for everything. In any condition we have to say Alhamdulillah for everything, because our body, everything, it's a belonging of Allah. That's why we recite Inna Lillahi wa Inna Ilayhi Rajiun, because everything comes from Allah. The health, the money, the house, the income, our children, our wife, our husband, everything is comes from Allah. So it come back, goes back to Allah. So all we have to do is have patience. So some of them who has a great trials on the earth, so it is not something they are sinners. Allah is testing them, and if they have committed some sins, Allah is basically purifying them by putting more trials on that. Because the more great trials you have, Allah is testing your more faith. The more trials you go through, Allah is taking you more higher.